If you've been around for a long time, you've probably at least once heard the name Synergy. This is a fairly popular KVM software, basically sharing your keyboard and mouse between different computers. You can do this with hardware devices, and nowadays a lot of people do this, but software solutions are also fairly popular as well. And whilst I was aware of the software, I wasn't aware of the really weird history it has, of it starting from a proprietary idea, then becoming open source, then being proprietary again, then being open source again. And the only reason I bothered to find out about this is recently this appeared, Deskflow. Deskflow is now the new name for the Synergy Community Edition, and this is the upstream of the commercial Synergy product. And much like Bitwarden and GitLab, Synergy is an open core product. So Deskflow is open source. This is licensed under the GPL v2. You can do whatever you want with it under the terms of that license. You can go and fork the project, you can redistribute it, you can do basically whatever you want. Now, Synergy, this is a proprietary project, but is built off of the open core, the open source project Deskflow, alongside proprietary editions, adding in various commercial functionality, dealing with license keys and other things you do in commercial products. Now, here's a question for you. How many of you actually make use of Synergy or now make use of Deskflow? Better yet, how many of you make use of projects like Input Leap, or what it forked from, Barrier? Let me know down below. But let's get into the history of the Synergy project, because all of these things are linked together. Synergy in its true form started in 2001, but it actually had ties to a project a few years earlier than that, in 1996. This was a proprietary tool called Cosmos Synergy, created by Richard Lee and Adam Feder. This was made as an in-house tool at Cosmic Software, a subsidiary of Silicon Graphics. Now, because of this subsidiary nature, most of their engineers didn't just use a single machine. They had both an Erix machine and a Windows machine at the same desk. Nowadays, hardware KVMs are relatively cheap and you can get them on Amazon fairly easily. Back in the early 2000s, back in the late 90s, that wasn't the case and they were considerably more expensive. And for their engineers, this solved a relatively annoying problem that didn't have a relatively good solution at the time, and it kept going for a couple of years. Eventually, the project was taken over by Chris Schoenman. But the problem is Cosmo never decided to turn Cosmo Synergy into a product. Then in the year 2000, SGI, Silicon Graphics, shut down the company. Whilst Chris couldn't take the Cosmo Synergy code with him, he could certainly take the idea, and that's exactly what he did. In 2001, wrote a new implementation entirely from scratch. This became Synergy. But when it was first made, it didn't have the Windows and Erix support that Cosmo Synergy had. This version only had support for the X Window system on Linux. And unlike Cosmo Synergy in the past and Synergy today, the original Synergy was not proprietary software or an open core model. It was regular old FOSS, free and open source software. It was licensed under the GPL v2. Come 2002, Windows support was also added, and then in 2003, macOS support was added as well. By this point, now all three of the major operating systems were supported by the project. And for the majority of people, this basically solved everything they wanted from KVM software. Yes, there are additional functionalities you can add into it. Yes, you can keep working on the project, but the core basic functionality of taking your cursor that is on your Linux X11 machine, having it go straight over to your macOS machine, and then over to your Windows machine, all of that just worked. As such, and because life gets in the way, Chris had other priorities take over the project, and development slowed down in 2006. Now, this was still prior to the company coming along that now runs Synergy even existed. That comes along in a couple of years. and it was still a fairly small scale open source project like any other out there, so it's completely understandable that you just have other things to do in life, right? Like, a lot of people will make a terminal or anything else out there, and they get it to a state where it's pretty good, and they just have other things to do and just move on to something else. But that does not mean that everybody else is done with the project. Come 2008, a new fork was made called Synergy Plus, started by Soren Sabania. In 2009, someone called Nick Bolton began contributing to the project and later took on responsibility for leading the project. This is when Simless was created. Simless is the company that now develops the Synergy Open Core project and spends a lot of time also developing its Open Core, now being called Deskflow. And come 2010, donations were being accepted by the project to fund the project, to employ developers, and hopefully make a better project that everybody just generally wants to be using. Now, whilst there was this legal entity in the form of Simless, it was still just starting up as a seriously developed project. There is a lot of projects that have, like, corporations or businesses built up around them, but aren't really that big yet. It's just something there to protect the trademark and things like that. And come 2011, Synergy Plus was renamed back into Synergy, and Q Synergy by Volker Lanz was added as the GUI for the project. Q, obviously, meaning it's a Qt project. This became the basis for the software known as Synergy today. So the original fork, the one made by Chris Schuerman, that one never continued. The fork running today is the one started by Soren Sabania, but it still tracks back to that original project. Now, this part was not listed in the history that Synergy and Deskflow provides. In 2014, that's when things started getting a little bit weird with the Simless company and the Synergy project. So, Synergy, GPL input sharing software, gone paid. You could still access the source code of the project. Now, most projects also provide free binaries as well. In the case of Synergy, they were now locking the binaries behind a paywall. So if you wanted a binary, you either had to pay them or compile the software yourself, or it being on Linux, it was probably going to be in your repos as well. So it's not something that really mattered for Linux users, but on Windows, on macOS, would be a little bit tedious and would encourage a lot of people to just go and pay for the software. I do think you should pay for software, and I don't think doing this is inherently a bad thing, but springing it on people does seem a little bit weird. Now, whilst the Synergy project originally started on X11 and on Linux, Wayland support didn't start even trying to be developed until 2016, but due to limitations, known as Wayland, they struggled to progress past a lot of the security limitations built into Wayland, and even to this day, Wayland support is considered experimental and very much a work in progress. Now, 2017 is when things really started to change. This is when Synergy 2 was launched. This was a user-friendly proprietary tool for less technical users. Now, whilst this was being built off of a GPL V2 project, and normally that would make it very hard to make a proprietary project, when most of the development is done by Simless employees, and those employees already giving away their rights to the code to their employer, it's a lot easier to do. Replacing anything that might not be written by them is fairly simple, and that's what ended up happening. The problem is in 2018, due to the stability issues with Synergy 2, it was rolled back to being a beta. So even though they made this proprietary solution, they couldn't really go with it. But also, when you have a company that tries to make a proprietary solution, you're gonna have the community around it think, okay, what are you doing exactly? And the last version of Synergy before Synergy 2 was forked into another project. This project became known as barrier. Now, because they've changed the upstream, the Synergy Community Edition over to something new, it now points to Deskflow, but originally, this would have said to Synergy. Now, Deskflow was in development until 2021. And again, development slowed down, but also there was a bit of drama, and this became another project called Input Leap. And this project is still being developed today. Now, most of the reasons for the fork are completely sensible. One of them is kinda dumb though. Active barrier maintainers have moved here November 11th, 2021. The reasons are the following. All important parts of the project were controlled by Walker0643. No one knows the real identity of that person. Completely valid. Walker0643 has not been active for 2 years and did not give administrative access to anyone else, which caused operational issues maintaining the project. Also, completely valid. I would not want to be running through a repo that nobody really has the ability to actually properly do anything with. The name Dobochi is not professional and should not be associated to a popular project. Now, when I first read this, I had literally no idea what was being said here. I have never heard the term debauchery before. I guess it's related to the term debauchery. But like, unless you're someone who is, I don't know, 100 years old, you probably never use the term anyway, and never even think about what the term means. Also, this is an open source project. It's not like a business running this, so it not being a professional name just literally doesn't matter. But even if the name reason was kind of stupid, I do think these two reasons here are completely legitimate reasons to go and fork the project. And then if the main maintainer is going to move over to it, makes a lot of sense. Now, whilst I said Wayland development started in 2016, it didn't really finish in 2016. So it actually restarted on the barrier fork and then later moved into Input Leap and then moved into Synergy. Now in 2023, Synergy 3 was launched, and this was based off of the Synergy 1 fork, so what is now known as Deskflow. The project started by Soren many, many years ago. And then this year, Deskflow became the new name of the Synergy 1 Synergy Community Edition, which now creates a very interesting link between the projects. As I said, now it says that Barrier is based off of Deskflow, even though Deskflow never actually existed as a name back when Barrier was forked, because the way GitHub does like fork links is weird and doesn't actually create like a proper fork. It just has everything pointing back to that same source. Now, even though Deskflow is the name they're going with now, nothing changes with the Input Leap project. They're still doing their own thing. They're still based off of the open source project. They can do whatever they want. But hey, this is as good a time as any to talk about the history of Synergy. They have a new name for the community project. Hopefully it means they put more effort into that and, you know, do all of that fun stuff. And, you know, that's good for everybody, because at the end of the day, if stuff is developed in Deskflow, that can then be moved over to other projects because it's still all GPL v2 code, which is very cool to see. So let me know down below, are you a Synergy user, a Deskflow user, a Barrier or Input Leap user? I'd love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Libera Pay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and I'm gonna float away, I guess.